Well, howdy YouTube family. It's Bolt CRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. Today we are talking about five steps for being successful in CRNA school clinically. I've been having a lot of CRNA students here lately that I've been precepting in the anesthesia realm and to the perioperative period, and I've been thinking of things that maybe that they're struggling with or maybe things that they need more help on, or let's get into it. First thing you need to do, show up early for your case. Don't show up 15 minutes before you're supposed to begin the case, running in, you're stressed out, you don't know where your supplies are at, they've changed your room from OR2 to OR8 and you're lost trying to figure out where you're going. You showed up and the CRNA is already there before you and they're already assembling drugs and the equipment for the supplies for the case and stuff. That looks really, really bad. They're probably going to take that out on you if you're showing up and they're having to set up the room for you because you're there late. So show up early. It's going to decrease your stress level. It's going to decrease problems that you're going to be having with preceptors. There's a lot of unpredictable things that can happen in anesthesia, and sometimes your cases can get moved around. Sometimes the case might get changed. Sometimes the surgeon may want to start a little early and you don't find out about it until you get there. And so as a student, you really want to be there early enough that you can avoid problems with that. It will make the rest of your day go much smoother. It gives you time to set up everything the way you want it to. A lot of times students are slower about finding supplies and drawing up drugs and setting up things you need to set up. So it'll allow you to do all that in advance and feel more comfortable. And it'll also give you time to go see the patient. It's always better for you to have seen the patient or at least introduced yourself to the patient before the CRNA or the physician anesthesiologist shows up and they're talking to the patient. It's best that you've already assembled some data on them and you already kind of know what's going on and already are prepared to maybe present the patient and clinical findings that you've assessed before they show up and they're going there to assess the patient. Second tip that I would give you is study up on your meds and the case the night before. You don't want to go in the day of and say you've got a spine surgery you're working on and you had no idea that they probably are going to be doing nerve monitoring and they don't want to use paralytic on those types of cases. And that's typically what the situation is going to be like on a spine case. But if you haven't researched it at all yet, you can't say, oh, I just didn't know that about this case, and you've set up paralytics and you have no idea what's going on. The CRNA is not going to take that well. They might ask you to sit out for this case. They might write that on your clinical evaluation for the day that you were not prepared, that you would have administered an unsafe or improper anesthetic for this type of surgery. So you really want to look up what's going on with the type of case you're doing. There's a couple different apps that are really good at that. I usually recommend Vargo app for these types of things because it gives you at least some baseline information of typical things that you're expecting. They're going to probably, whether they're going to tuck both arms. Usually do they start two different IVs because of this type of thing? Is this expected to be a very bloody procedure? Do you need to make sure you have a type and screen on this patient? Things like that. So it's always important, research that, know that the night before, don't come in the morning of surgery and not understand. If you look on the app or you look up on the research and it says typically like remifentanil is used, like say for the spine case, you need to understand some, basic pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics of remifentanil. Brush that up and make sure that you're good to go on that information because you'll probably get quizzed about it. If you don't know the correct dosages of this medication or how it works, that's not good. That's going to look really bad when you come into the day of. So research up your medicines, research up the types of cases and in the different ways that it can be done, and have that fresh in your mind, ready to go, and be prepared to be quizzed on that stuff when you start surgery. Third tip, have a solid anesthetic plan ready to go. Have it written down, the meds you want to use, the types of milligrams of what you're wanting to use, why you're wanting to use these meds. whether you're going to intubate with this certain type of thing or this certain type of thing. Have an idea of what you're doing with this case. How long is this case? How much fluid do you plan to give? Do you expect blood loss? What are you going to give if you do have blood loss? You know, what kind of vasopressors are you planning to use? Does this patient have cardiac history? Are they an older person who you're anticipating having problems with hypotensions in the case? Are you already going to have phenylephrine mixed up in a bag and ready to infuse on a pump? You know, you need to have all these things written down, ready to go. I always had a notepad in my back pocket, like one of those little small ones like that. And I would just write the case type, the basic information of like BMI and things like that about the patient that would be pertinent to the anesthetic plan, the weight of the patient, the drugs that I was going to be giving, the milligrams, the equipment that I expected to use. And then the morning of, when I came to meet up with the CRNA and say, okay, so I'm here with you today. These are our cases. Our first case is this. This was my anesthetic plan. This is what I think would be a good idea for this type of case. They may disagree with you. They may say, hey, you know, I don't use ketamine in these types of cases. I prefer this drug instead. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with them telling you that they prefer to not use ketamine because they don't like it or whatever it is you choose to use. They may very well tell you that they're going to use something different. Maybe you suggested succinylcholine and they're like, I don't like succinylcholine. I'm going to use rock. That's fine. You know, that will happen. So don't let that freak you out when they tell you they disagree with this. What would be a problem is if they say your plan is unsafe. Now, if they think that your plan is dangerous or unsafe or it's negligent, then that's a different issue. Then you need to discuss with them what exactly you said that was totally incorrect or dangerous. But you need to at least have a good, solid anesthetic plan written down, ready to go, ready to recite it to the CRNA the morning of the case. So have that ready, have it written down, and come in prepared. Another tip for, this is my fourth tip, for students who are coming in, especially new students who are just starting their clinicals and just getting in their first couple rotations, focus on one step at a time. Don't let yourself get so bogged down with the multiple things you're doing at once, especially at the beginning and the end of a case. There's a lot of different things that you're having to focus on and get done. And a lot of times students will get confused about which step they're on, or they'll skip a step that they need to be doing, like they forgot to suction the patient, now they're ready to extubate, and you're like, have you suctioned the patient out yet? Is there a bunch of saliva and snot in the back of their throat that they're about to laryngospasm on? Because we skipped that step and now we're trying to jump to extubate because you're so nervous and you notice, oh my gosh, they're breathing good on their own and their eyes are starting to move a little, and you realize, well, you never suctioned this patient. You should have suctioned them like three steps ago when they were much deeper in their anesthetic. I find that students will forget certain steps or they try and do multiple steps all at one time when they're not very good at any of the steps yet, and they're not very comfortable doing any of them, but they're trying to do multiple things at one time and they're messing up most of the steps they're doing, or they're half doing it, and then they, you know, run into trouble down the line because they only half did this other step or they forgot it altogether. So my advice is, when you're focusing on doing stuff, especially at the beginning and end of surgery, focus on one step at a time. Make up a little list in your head or even on your piece of paper, the notepad I told you. Create a notepad where you have like, okay, steps 1 through 9. I wanna do this, oral airway, suction, blah, blah, blah. And you do all that. And then when it's time at the end of the case, there's no problem. Pull out that list. And if I see you looking at that list, it just means, okay, this person's trying their hardest to be prepared and do things appropriately. And then if I see you, you know, going through those steps and you're doing it all appropriately and good, awesome. I would much rather you do that as a trainee than to try and remember it off the top of your head, do it incorrectly, jump around, you know, miss a bunch of steps or half do the steps and provide not a high quality anesthetic and maybe something dangerous. My fifth big step for students is have resilient skin. Imagine your skin is Teflon and go into your clinical rotations being tough and impenetrable. You know, if you go home and get upset and you have a rough day and you want to cry about it, you know, that's okay because everyone needs an emotion release at some point. But I would say in clinicals, be as resilient as you can be and try to not let things get to you, because honestly, it's going to be hard. Training in anesthesia is going to be very hard. Training to be a CRNA is very hard. There's a lot of really tough people out there. Not only is what we do a very stressful, tough job, but there's a lot of people in the anesthesia world who have kind of a tough personality, and they're not very kind, and they treat nurse anesthesia residents and physician anesthesia residents pretty rough, and can talk down to them and treat you kind of like garbage at times. I try to never ever do that, and even if I'm in a stressed out moment where I'm thinking quickly and I'm needing someone to get out of my way or do something quickly, I try and still maintain some level of professionalism and courteousness as much as I can. But yeah, there are some people out there who don't try and do that. They don't use much of their emotional energy to try and make you feel decent, and they can be hard to work with. And I remember in training, I had preceptors and people like that who would really just make you feel terrible. And if you let that get to you and you let that sink in, you let that unkind word they said to you or a really critical assessment at the end of the day that really wasn't that fair to you really hit you hard, it can really rock you down and it can mess you up for the future. Like, you're going to go in the next day for clinical and you're going to fumble around and make mistakes, and you're going to be terrified of looking like a fool again or making that same mistake someone criticized you on yesterday about. You're going to be so in your head, you're actually going to do worse than you normally would have done. So I feel like it's very important for students to be resilient, especially in the beginning. Like, your first year of training, you're going to get a lot of flack, you're going to get a lot of critique because you're not going to be amazing at that point. You're going to make a lot of mistakes, you're going to need a lot of things to improve on, and it's hard to constantly be hearing that you need to work on this, you need to improve on this, you're not good at this, and then internally you're also beating your own self up about it. So I'd say being resilient and having really thick skin is very important for a student in the beginning of your training. And I'm not saying ignore every feedback that you get, because a lot of feedback you get is helpful. That's stuff you need to maybe work on or improve on. But don't let it sink into your core of who you are. Realize who you are as a person. Keep that deep down in there of who you are and that you're an important person. These things that you're doing, mistakes you're making, they don't mean you are a crappy person or insignificant or incompetent as a human. Just means you're learning a new skill, a new thing. You're not amazing at it. You will get better at it. And it's just something you're working on right now. So have tough, thick skin and you'll do well. Well, all right, guys, that was everything. Those are my five, tips for SRNAs who are starting clinicals and really just trying to get their feet wet and figure out how to do this anesthesia thing. It's hard, it's tough, it's a rough time. I try and be as nice and polite and kind as I can be because I remember acutely how hard it was. So I want to hear from you guys in the comments below if you had any tips that helped you get through anesthesia training, and maybe even if you just want to share a story of a time that you got you got ripped a new one by somebody and it really tore you up and how you got over it. Because I think sometimes other people just need to hear that this happens to other students and trainees too, and it's not just them, and they're not just the one unique terrible person who makes mistakes. And we all make mistakes. We all had troubles in training, and nobody starts off being great at anesthesia. So anyway, I want to hear from you guys in the comments below. Of course, go follow me over on Instagram. Also, TikTok, guys. I'm over on TikTok now. If you followed to the end of this video here, you need to be on TikTok following me because you're an OG. And my videos are kind of like funny, goofy little short clips on TikTok. It's Bolt CRNA over there. Of course, the memberships. We do the live chats every month. We've got the exclusive behind the scenes videos. I do mock interviews for students over on the membership. So go over to the memberships tab here on YouTube and join up in the memberships. I'd love to have you guys over there too. And until next time, guys, that's Bolt out.